Hi, I'm Julie Gall. I'm Professor of Organisational Psychology here at Birkbeck, and I'm Programme Director for the new Professional Doctorate in Evidence-Based Human Resource Management.
Hi, my name is Rob Breen. I'm Professor of Organisational Psychology at Queen Mary University of London and also Visiting Professor at Birkbeck to work on this programme with Julie and others. Evidence-based HR is essentially just evidence-based practice applied to the particular discipline of HR. As many people are aware, or they've heard of things like evidence-based medicine, evidence-based policymaking, evidence-based policing, it's the same principles applied to HR as a specific area of management. So it involves the use of multiple sources of evidence, looking critically at the quality of that to try and answer questions both about potential HR problems or issues or opportunities and potential interventions or solutions. And it's been around, I guess, for about 30 or 40 years, something like that, in other fields, but it's relatively new in HR. So HR, and certainly the CIPD in the UK, it's one of the only professional bodies so far within HR to actually try and specifically adopt this approach. And as many people will be aware, there's things like people analytics, HR analytics, which is great, but that's really only one particular area of evidence. So within evidence-based practice, of course, we look at organisational data, but we also look at scientific evidence. We also look at practitioners' professional expertise and knowledge. And also importantly, we look at stakeholders' values and perspectives as well. So what we see is that HR has become more and more, I guess, interested in data and evidence broadly. Evidence-based practice is something that brings those different sources of data and evidence together to help improve the effectiveness of HR. And it's come at, I guess, an important and a good time because for decades, HR has had debates about its value, whether it's adding value or not, or its effectiveness. So evidence-based practice and using this is one way, and I think it seems to be a very good way of trying to improve the effectiveness of the HR function in any organisation.
Well, this course is unique because it's the first course in the UK, possibly in the world at this level, looking at evidence-based human resource management with a group of people who have practitioner experience, could be 10 to 15 years of experience working in HR. They'll be really looking at evidence in practice around the key areas of human resource management, be that reward, development, remuneration, talent management. It will really provide the HR professionals with a framework for making much more improved decision making. So a framework for really providing evidence from multiple sources of data, which provides insight into improving ways of working. And it's a really conscious process. So it's a conscious process of decision making, which looks at these multiple sources of evidence in a critical and informed way, whilst recognising the importance of the organisation and also the importance of the experts and stakeholders working within that organisation. So really science and practice coming together to help HR professionals make really informed decisions. People who join the programme will have an MSc in human resource management, merit or a distinction, but they may have an MSc in a related social science area as well. And those people who've been working in HR practice for a number of years, maybe at a senior level, who want to look at challenging problems in the workplace and look at them critically to help their thinking and also help improve their organisational success and productivity. It certainly is a challenging programme. The programme will be a combination of talk sessions, which are run on weekends, Fridays and Saturdays. So six programs over 2 years. And in addition to completing a thesis, which is a little shorter than the normal type of PhD thesis, so 50,000 words rather than 80,000 words, but it's about bringing the best scientific knowledge and the best practitioner and organisational knowledge together to help and provide solutions and suggestions about managing people in working contexts.